Hi, today we're in the bathroom again and I'm going to show you how to do period curls with a modern angle, not twist but angle. I know the light is falling a bit funny, excuse that, but this is the only way I can show you. So first of all, I've got wet hair. Normally you do this on dry hair and then just moisten it with a spray. I'm going to do this different because I haven't got that much time. Either you can use when you haven't got that much time, or in my case I'm just going to leave it in for a lot longer to make sure that the result is perfect, because I don't want to put too much product in. So I've brushed my hair through. Next thing I'm going to use as the curling agent, if you like, is the Aloe First spray. It's got lots of herbs in it, so it's good for you as well. I'm just going to spray that on as well. Oops, I've sprayed the mirror in the back. That's no good. A bit haphazard here. I should have done it this way around. There we go. All right. Great. So let me just wipe. Excuse me, let's just wipe the mirror at the back. The way, as in the way, because I will need to roller those up as well. My fringe, I don't like the word bangs really, it sounds somehow a bit crude, but there you go. Nothing wrong with it really, it's just me, not used to using that. There we go. So what I'll quickly do is I'll roll those as well whilst I'm at it. I think I'm going to go for 3 bits today. I'm using Velcro rollers for this today. There we go. Next lot, next side. I think I've got to get myself some longer ones so I don't have to part this, because my hair will go all wavy, I'm sure. I'm not doing it on set. That means they're coming forward, they're not going up. So this today I'm not doing a lift, I'm just rolling the ends. And I'm using the smallest rollers I have for that. And it would be a good idea if I do this properly. So hang on. There we go. There we go. So for the period look, you will need 2 rags. You see mine are pretty long. They have to be twice as long as your hair. Okay? And the way I'm doing it today is this. I'm now going to part the top. And I'm going to turn around so that you can see. So I've taken part of the top, I'm just going to curl this up for a minute and tuck it out the way. And now I'm going to work with the bottom lot. I'm going to take the rag and place it above so that you've got some left to tie. Clip that in place like so. Now you're going to take your hair and roll the hair around the rag. As you notice, I'm not tightening it up because I do not want teeny itsy bitsy corkscrews. Right, now this is the crucial bit. Once you get to the ends, I hope you can see this, then you lay them round. Take the cloth in the same direction, fold the ends in, and now wrap the cloth around the hair all the way up. That's to protect the hair. Right, now I'm at the top. There's my clip. Take the clip out. Take the other end. Tie a knot. So there you have your first one, all wrapped up. Now you do exactly the same with the next knot. I only do two because you only need to do two. Just going to brush through once more. There we go. Take my next rag. Same procedure. Put that right up on the top with some left over so that you can tie. Clip it to hold it in place. Actually, I'll do it this way around. There we go. Now, take the next hair lot. Have I got it all? I think I do. Take the rag and wrap the hair around the rag. I'm getting to the ends again. Right, fold those in. Take the cloth do this very neatly. There we go. Take it all the way to the top. Now undo the clip. Take the second bit here. Right, now you have two choices. You can either sleep in this all night, or like I'm going to show you now, I'm going to go downstairs and put my hood on for at least an hour. No, I think longer, because my hair is wet. So I think I'll put it on for an hour or two, and just so that it can get really the heat in. I didn't put any heat protection on here, on the tails, but I will in the front. And I'm using this, even though the Aloe First actually also does protect. I'm just going to make double sure and just put here on the front a little bit. And I'm going off to my hood. You've seen how I work my hood, so I don't need to show you that anymore. And I'll get back to you tomorrow morning. I'm just going to dry this extra off under the hood for an hour or two, leave it in all night, and I'll get back to you tomorrow morning to show you the results. Bye. Last night I rolled up my hair, you know, the period, vintage period curls, and well, it wasn't exactly a fail, but what has happened is overnight it hasn't quite dried. So I've still got the rolls underneath here. So I've decided I'm just going to put up my hair like this today, leave it in for another few hours. The ends are still dry, and so is the top, but right in the middle, my hair is still wet. That's what happens if you do your hair up like that, in the rag roll, wet. That is why most people put them in just clean, blow dry, and or natural dry, and then spritz on whatever they need to spritz on, and then roll them up. So I think in the long run that's maybe better, especially if you've got long, fine, thick hair like I have. So I've decided to go like this today. for a few more hours, at least sort of like say till maybe midday. I'm just looking at the watch there, maybe till midday. So I will show you the results when I have, when the hair is dry. I hope it's not a fail. With my hair, you never quite know. Alright, I've done it before, it worked fine, but I don't know, this time it's taken a lot longer. So anyway, see you later, bye!
An old mill had particular resonance here. My great-great-grandfather built 25 mills, cotton mills, in and around East Lancashire, just like this one. Yeah. So for me, it's really my DNA, these sorts of buildings. See us employing here in Burnley in the next couple of years, as we continue to grow. I want to put Burnley on the map, and this is my way of doing that.
Despite the efforts of people like Nigel and Mark, there's still no denying that Burnley continues to have serious issues. Latest figures show that the number of young people looking for work has gone up, and almost a third of children in Burnley are still living below the poverty line. So it's refreshing to hear some good news for a change.
So here we are at the official party to celebrate Burnley's award as the most enterprising place in the UK.
How do we do that? Well, the council leader thinks it's down to a team effort.
Business and council have been working very effectively together to grow the conditions for business and for employment options, which the town really needs.
And this Burnley fan's been coming to the town for 50 years now.
I don't think any of you should pretend that all the problems that Burnley's faced have gone. But I think that until the sense of returning the economy, yes, I don't usually overstate it, but certainly don't understand the improvement we've made.
Shorty time.